Infrastructure as code is something you've probably heard a lot about, but how does it relate to Azure SQL Database? Check it out in this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Today, I'm joined by Hamish Watson. Thanks for being here today.
Thank you, Anna. It's really good to be part of this. Yeah.
Awesome. And before we kick it off, I wanted to, you know, take a moment to let you tell us a little bit more about yourself and what you do.
Yeah, sure thing. I'm Hamish Watson. I live in New Zealand, and I'm a data platform MVP. And basically, for me, one of the cool things about being a data platform MVP is it has the word platform in there. And for me, I run my own company that is dedicated to data, Azure, and DevOps. And all those things need a platform to run. And I've been in IT for a long time. But over the course of that time, both my career has changed, but also the way that I use databases has changed. You know, I've gone from being an administrator to more of an engineer. Using DevOps somewhere in there to make stuff go and make my work life better.
Awesome. Great. And today we're going to be talking about infrastructure as code and Azure. And I really like your title, you know, a match made in the cloud. So can you tell us a little bit like about what that means and kind of what you want to show us today?
Yeah, sure. It goes to what I was talking about before about the platform, right? For me, years ago, I realized that clicking next wasn't the greatest thing because I don't really concentrate that well. And also, it's not scalable. I can't click next 1,000 times. And so over the course of my career, I realized that there were better ways of provisioning things. And I used to talk to developers, and I noticed they coded, and then they taught me a whole heap of stuff, and I deployed stuff for them. And I realized that there were better ways of doing it. And so I got on board with infrastructure as code early on. I used PowerShell to do a whole heap of stuff that normally I would, you know, either do myself or other people would do. And the other side of this is around standardization, right? Having a script that not only I know will provision the same thing every time, but more importantly, I can collaborate. I can share the script with you, or doing it properly, I'll have it in source control and you can grab it. And then, you know, as time went on, automation became way, way easier. So instead of sharing it with you, we get the machines to run it. And again, you know, we've got something that's consistent, it's standardized. We can test it and we can parameterize it, right? So today I want, you know, a Azure SQL database of this size. Well, feed in a new parameter and it's now this size. Or these, you know, you can change all the things. But again, having it in source control and version audited is brilliant. And for me, it went the next level when, you know, I started provisioning resources in Azure. And of course, the first time I provisioned something, I used the UI because you've got to understand some of the things there. But basically, my philosophy is, you know, try it once in the UI and then look at how you can, you know, automate it and provision it with code.
Awesome. Great. Well, you know, I'm inspired. Like, let's take a look.
All righty. Well, I've got a couple of things that I'm going to demo for us today, which hopefully will help people. Let's jump into it. So here we are in the Azure portal. And I'm going to show you one of the things that really changed how I do stuff. I early on started using the Azure Cloud Shell. One of the things I love about the Azure Cloud Shell is it's basically my toolkit anywhere in the world. You know, I can swap computers. I can be anywhere. I can even use my phone, which I have done. But I can use Azure Cloud Shell to basically write code. It's really awesome. So if you use Visual Studio Code, you'll be used to, writing different code in there. The Azure Cloud Shell has a cut down version of it. So what we're going to do today is I'm going to use Terraform to spin up some of my resources. So I'm just going to initialize Terraform, and what this is going to do is we are going to create some resources in Azure today. And so I've initialized it. I'm just going to run plan, which will probably tell me that I haven't written the best code in the world, but that's okay for today. And what we're going to do is while this spins up, we're going to create a SQL server up in Azure. And we're going to do some firewall rules, and I would probably want to come back and reconfigure these, but that's okay. We're going to create a database. Oh, and this is all going to be in a resource group. So we've done our plan. We didn't get any errors, which is awesome. And now I'm going to apply it, and I'm going to do auto approve. And this is quite important, because if I did not do auto approve, it's going to ask me a question, you know, do you want to deploy this? And yeah, normally you have to type in yes, but I'm just going to let it automatically do it. So I'll do the auto approve. So this will take a wee while to deploy. So while that's deploying, how about we look at some other ways that we can deploy up into Azure? And here we have another way. So I'm going to use ARM templates, which is Azure Resource Manager templates. So if you've deployed anything in Azure, you'll have used the Azure Resource Manager, right? So you've clicked create database, create, you know, server, create whatever, logic apps, you name it. That's the beauty of platform. So I have an ARM template that I have created, and I'm going to deploy this using Azure PowerShell on my machine. So what we'll do, again, this will take a wee while, so we'll let this bubble away, and we'll now come back and have a look at my... Oh, this is brilliant. We have the database created via Azure CLI. So why don't we quickly just go back into the portal and have a look and see what we've deployed. Alrighty, so let's close down Azure Cloud Shell. We have a new resource group here. This is pretty cool. And you'll notice we have a couple of databases. We have our SQL Server that hosts our different databases. So you'll see here, my Terraform script created a Terraform database, and my Azure CLI script created a database. And so again, this is a couple of different ways that we can create things. And so very soon, we're going to have another database in here that the ARM template has deployed. So why is this important? Well, the main thing about being able to script all these resources is we can now fold that into a CI/CD pipeline. It means that when we are deploying our code, our apps, whatever, instead of having someone do it, we'll just spin up things as we want. And the best part is we'll destroy or delete them when we're finished with them. So we'll spin them up, do what we need to, and then just remove them. Because this is the magic of using infrastructure as code, right? It's declarative. All my things should be inferior. So I don't really care about the state of them. I'm just going to spin them up when I want. When I'm done, they're gone. And this kind of changes the way we look at resources. You know, there's that saying, you know, treat them as cattle rather than pets. I still care about my database, but it may be a lot shorter lived. I may only have it up for a couple of minutes and then get rid of it. And I will deploy my database from source control. All the things that I need to configure and manage it are coming from source control. And so what I'm hoping today is that my very simple scripts, I appreciate that they're a one line, I should have some exception handling, but I'm hoping that it gives you a way to go out and try things out in Azure. Because the best part is, try them, spin it up, and then delete it. That way you're saving any costs that you might incur. Alrighty, why don't we quickly click refresh? And there it is. That is fantastic. We now have three databases that we've used three different ways of creating them. And you know what? I could still use the portal. I could still, you know, add a database in there if I needed to.
Awesome. Thanks, Hamish. This has been really interesting. You've shown me some things I haven't even seen before. So you showed us how to deploy Azure SQL database with Terraform, with Visual Studio Code, using the Azure CLI, and also using ARM templates. And I think it's great advice that you're telling our viewers is just, you know, go out, try this, get started, and then it's really going to open up a world of opportunities. So I really just want to thank you for being on the show today, Hamish. And we're actually going to do a follow-up video to this where we'll dive a little bit deeper into a slightly different scenario. So if you like this video, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and let us know what you're doing with Infrastructure as Code. See you next time on Data Exposed.